importance of cyanobacteria. Introduction. Cyanobacteria are prokaryotic oxygenic protophylls found almost every conceivable habitat on Earth. They exist in different morphologies including unicellular and filamentous forms. While unicellular types exist as single cells, suspended or benthic or aggregates, filamentous types may be thin or thick, single trichome or bundles either with or without a sheath. Cyanobacteria are able to perform different modes of metabolism with the capacity to switch from one mode to another. All cyanobacteria carry out oxygenic photosynthesis, but some cyanobacterial species can switch to the typical bacterial anoxygenic photosynthesis using sulfide as an electron donor. Under anoxic conditions and during the dark, cyanobacteria carry out fermentation. Some cyanobacteria form heterocysts and have the ability to fix atmospheric nitrogen. Phylogenetic analysis of cyanobacteria based on the 16S rRNA genes showed that they are a diverse monophyletic phylum of organisms with the bacterial radiation. Research on cyanobacteria in the last decades focused largely on their ecology, morphology, physiology, and the 16 rRNA based on the phylogeny, but relatively little has been done on the potential uses in biotechnology. The overwhelming available knowledge on the diversity and physiology of cyanobacteria serves as an excellent base for exploring their applications in biotechnology. In the last few years, cyanobacteria have gained much attention as a rich source of bioactive compounds and have been considered as one of the most promising groups of organisms to produce them. These cyanobacterial metabolites include antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral, anti-cancer, antiplasmodial, algicide, and immunosuppressive agents. Screening of cyanobacteria for antibiotics has opened a new horizon for discovering new drugs. Some cyanobacteria have also been found to intercellularly accumulate polyhydroxyalkanoates, in short called as the PHA, which are comparable in properties to polyethylene and polypropylene. These biodegradable plastics could replace oil-derived thermoplastics in some fields. Recent research on cyanobacteria has demonstrated that they form ideal consortia with chemotrophic bacteria and can effectively use to clean up oil-contaminated sediments and wastewaters. Cyanobacteria have many more biotechnological applications that await possible uses in mariculture, food, fuel, fertilizers, colorants, and production of various secondary metabolites, including toxins, vitamins, enzymes, and pharmaceuticals. Considering the diverse potential uses of cyanobacteria in biotechnology, the first one is cyanobacterial bioactive compounds. Cyanobacteria have been identified as a new and rich source of bioactive compounds. Isolated compounds belong to the groups of polyketidates, amides, alkaloids, fatty acids, indoles, and lipopeptides. Most of the bioactive compounds isolated from cyanobacteria tend to be lipopeptides, that is, they consist of an amino acid fragment linked to a fatty acid protein. The range of biological activity of secondary metabolites isolated from cyanobacteria includes antibacterial, antifungal, antialgal, antiprotozoan, and antiviral activities. Only few cyanobacteria produce bioactive compounds that show a broad spectrum of biological activities. For example, the Cyanobacterium formidium species has been reported to inhibit the growth of different gram-positive and gram-negative bacterial strains, yeast and fungi. Another example is the Lingbia majuscule that produces numerous chemicals including nitrogen-containing compounds, polyketides, lipopeptides, cyclic peptides and many others. The biological activity of these compounds is also diverse and includes protein kinase, C activators and tumor promoters. It also includes inhibitors of microtubulin assembly, antimicrobial and antifungal compounds and sodium channel blockers. Secondary metabolites with antibacterial activity are widely produced by cyanobacteria. These compounds are effective against gram-positive and or gram-negative bacteria. Both toxic and non-toxic strains of cyanobacteria are producers of antibacterial compounds that are distinct from cyanotoxins. Antifungal compounds include fishcillin A, hepalinodol, carazostatin, phytoloxylin, tolytoxin, skytophycin, toyokamycin, nostacyclamide, and nosodione produced by cyanobacteria belonging to the stignonematales, nostocales, and oscillatorolase. Additionally, cyanobacteria produce a broad spectrum of anti-algal compounds which may be used to control algal blooms. Cyanobacteria probably use these compounds in order to outcompete other microorganisms. Anti-algal compounds produced by cyanobacteria inhibit growth of algae, their photosynthesis, respiration, carbon uptake, enzymatic activity, and induce oxidative stress. In contrast to the large amount of antibacterial and anti-algal compounds isolated from cyanobacteria, there are only a few compounds that show antiviral properties. Although 2 to 10% of extracts of different cyanobacterial species have been shown to have antiviral activity. These include the acylated sulfoglycolipids from the Oscillatoria roi and the spirulin from Spirulina plantensis. The compounds isolated from Lingbia and the Formidium tenu have been shown to have the anti-HIV activity. The gamma-linolenic acid, also known in short as the GLA, found rich in S. plantensis and Arthrospira species, is medically important since it is converted in the human body into arachidonic acid and into prostaglandin E2. This compound has a lowering action on blood pressure and plays an important role in lipid metabolism. Some of the marine cyanobacteria constitute potential sources for large-scale production of vitamins, such as vitamins B and vitamin E. Some demonstrations showed that some cyanobacteria can produce thermostable enzymes. Out from 21 endonucleases from Formidium species, 4 enzymes that catalyze the hydrolysis of DNA and RNA were active in a wide range of temperatures from 15 to 60 degrees centigrade. Phenyltransferase enzymes catalyzing the consecutive condensation of homoallylic diophosphate of isopentyl diophosphates at temperature above 60 degrees centigrade have been isolated from the thermophilic cyanobacterium. Senococcus elongates, thermostable polyphosphate kinase from the thermophilic cyanobacterium. ATP regeneration system that could be used at high temperatures for effective production of D-amino acid dipeptidates. These enzymes and other heat-stable bioactive compounds are of great interest in biotechnology. Cyanobacteria have been used to synthesize isotopically labeled compounds such as sugars, lipids, and amino acids, which are nowadays commercially available. This is achieved by growing the cyanobacteria in photobioreactors and allowing them to photosynthetically transform simple labeled compounds such as 14 carbon dioxide, 13 carbon dioxide, 33 water, and 15 nitrogen into complex organics. Let us now see cyanobacteria as bioplastics. Like mentioned above, the polyhydroxyalkanoates, shortly called as the PHAs. In conditions of excess essential nutrients, many microorganisms usually assimilate and store nutrients for future consumption. Various storage materials have been identified in microorganisms, which include glycogen, sulfur, polyamino acids, polyphosphate, and lipids. The PHAs are lipodic material accumulated by a wide variety of microorganisms in the presence of abundant carbon sources. The assimilated carbon sources are biochemically processed into hydroxyalkanoate monomer units, polymerized, and then stored in the form of water-insoluble inclusions in the cell cytoplasm. PHA is a crystalline thermoplastic with properties comparable to that of polypropylene. PHA has been the focus of attention of the past three decades as a potential substitute for non-biodegradable petrochemical-based plastics. This is because PHA is an ideal biodegradable material that can completely mineralize into water and carbon dioxide by the action of naturally occurring microorganisms. In addition, PHA is also a biocompatible material and is being studied for its application in biomedical and biopharmaceutical fields. The idea of producing PHA from carbon dioxide is thought to contribute to a carbon neutral process for making plastics. The idea is also commercially attractive because then the production of PHA will be based on a readily available and free carbon and energy source, that is sunlight. Some cyanobacteria like the S. platensis can accumulate PHA under the phototrophic and or mixotrophic growth conditions with acetate. The PHA granules can be stained by Nile blue A and they appear as a discrete electron transparent granules in the cell cytoplasm. Cyanobacteria are of particular interest as the PHA producers because of their minimal nutrient requirements for growth and capability of accumulating PHA by oxygenic photosynthesis. Like higher plants, cyanobacteria fix carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and turn it into PHA under nitrogen limiting conditions. Most of the known cyanobacteria that are capable of synthesizing PHA usually accumulate PHAs amounting to less than 6% weight of their cell dry weight. Spirulina platensis have been known to have reported to accumulate a maximum of 6% weight and 7% weight of CDV of PHA under mixotrophic conditions. Poly-3-hydroxybutyrate is the most common type of the PHA synthesized by most bacteria. This is also the most common type of PHA synthesized by cyanobacteria. Wisenzi et al. In 1990 found that when spirulina was cultivated under photoautotrophic conditions, the P3HB content was low, which was about 0.3 weight percent of CDW. While under mixotrophic growth conditions, in the presence of acetate, the P3HB level accounted to about 3% weight of the CDW. It is known that the synthesis of P3HB is primarily regulated by 3-ketothiolase, which is inhibited by high concentrations of a free enzyme called the COA. High concentration of intracellular acetyl-CoA favors the synthesis and accumulation of P3HB. Thus, when acetate is present in the growth medium, the intracellular acetyl-CoA concentration increases at the expense of the free CoA pool, resulting in enhancement of the P3HB biosynthesis. The role of P3HB in cyanobacteria is to provide cells with a mechanism of removal of excess reducing equivalents resulting from a disruption of the balanced formulation of ATP to NADPH from photosynthesis. Let us now see cyanobacterial consortia for bioremediation purposes. Many studies have reported the ability of cyanobacteria to oxidize oil components and other complex organic compounds such as surfactants and herbicides. However, recent studies have demonstrated that is indeed not the cyanobacteria that is responsible for the degradation of these compounds, but the associated aerobic organotrophic bact. In spite of that, the presence of cyanobacteria alongside with the aerobic organotrophs facilitated the degradation process, and both groups constituted ideal consortia for degradation of petroleum and other complex organic compounds. While aerobic bacteria directly degrade these components, cyanobacteria play an equally important indirect role in biodegradation by, number one, providing them with oxygen, which is a byproduct of photosynthesis, which is needed for the breakdown of aromatic rings. Number two, providing them with simple organics, which is produced by photosynthesis and fermentation. And number three, providing them with fixed nitrogen through nitrogen fixing strains, which is often limited in different environments. Abed and Coaster in the year 2005 demonstrated the capability of an Oscillatoria gamma proteobacteria consortium to degrade phenethrin, dibenzothiophen, pristine and N-octadecane. This degradation rate of these compounds was enhanced in the presence of cyanobacterium. Similarly, Microclus conthonoplastis was found to form consortia with organotrophic bacteria, some of which were able to fix atmospheric nitrogen while others could degrade aliphatic heterocyclic organosulfur compounds as well. These indigenous consortia could be ideally used in bioremediation of polluted sites without the need to add new bacteria or fertilizers to the field. Cyanobacteria and their associated bacteria have also been successfully used in wastewater treatment. For example, cultures of Osculatoria species, the BDU30501, the Aptanocaspa species, the BDU16, and an halophilic bacterium, Halobacterium US101, were used to treat a factory effluent and resulted in reduction of calcium and chloride to levels that did not inhibit survival and multiplication of fish. Let us look at cyanobacteria as an alternative energy source. Cyanobacteria have been used to produce hydrogen gas that constitutes an alternative future energy source to the limited fossil fuel resources. The advantages of using biological hydrogen as a fuel are its eco-friendly nature, efficiency, renewability, and the absence of carbon dioxide emission during its production and utilization. Cyanobacteria produce hydrogen either as a byproduct of nitrogen fixation, when nitrogenase containing heterocystis cyanobacteria are grown under nitrogen limiting conditions, or by the reversible activity of hydrogenase's enzymes. Heterocystis cyanobacteria are thus more efficient in hydrogen production than non-heterocystis types. More than 14 cyanobacterial genera are known for their ability to produce hydrogen gas under various culture conditions. Anabiana species are able to produce significant amounts of hydrogen. Nitrogen-starved Anabiana cylindrica cells produce the highest amount of hydrogen, that is 30 milliliters of hydrogen per liter culture per hour. Gloeocapsa aplioca showed increase in hydrogen production under sulfur starvation, where S. platensis could produce hydrogen under complete dark and anoxia. Large-scale hydrogen production by the spirulina and the anabina species has been tried using different types of bioreactors that included the vertical column reactor, the tubular type, and flat panel photobioreactor. These reactors were designed to make use of solar light for illumination to maximize the area for incident light and to allow sterilization and hydrogen collection with convenience and ease. Nevertheless, the reactors are subjected to continuous modification in order to increase their productivity and to decrease costs of maintenance and production. Increased production of hydrogen was also achieved by genetically modifying the nitrogenase enzyme in hydrogen-producing strains. The ongoing research on hydrogen production by cyanobacteria focuses on finding new strains with higher potential to produce hydrogen, optimizing the mass production of hydrogen in bioreactors, and modifying the physiology and the genetic system of hydrogen-producing cyanobacteria to ensure maximum production of hydrogen. Let us now look at cyanobacteria as a biofertilizer. Heterocystis cyanobacteria and several non-heterocystis cyanobacteria are known for their ability to fix atmospheric nitrogen. The fertility of many tropical rice field soils has been mainly attributed to the activity of nitrogen-fixing cyanobacteria. Inoculation of cyanobacteria to increase the fertility of soils has been successfully attempted. For example, azolla was used as an organic fertilizer in rice cultivation in many countries. Addition of azolla was found to support the growth of soil microorganisms, including heterotrophic nitrogen fixers. Recently, nitrogen-fixing cyanobacteria have been reported to dominate desert crusts worldwide. This is believed to contribute significantly to the fertility of desert soils and may eventually facilitate vegetation of deserts. Let us look at cyanobacteria as a healthy food source. Strains of spirulina, anabina, and nostoc are consumed as human food in many countries, including Chile, Mexico, Peru, and Philippines. Arthrospira platensis, misidentified as S. platensis, is grown in large scale using either outdoor ponds or sophisticated bioreactors, but marketed in the form of powder, flakes, tablets, and capsules. It is used as a food supplement because of its richness in nutrients and digestibility. It contains more than 60% proteins and is rich in beta-carotene, thymine, and riboflavin, and is considered to be one of the richest sources of vitamin B12. Nostoc commune is rich in fibers and proteins and can play an important physiological and nutritional role in the human diet. Afanziomenon species is collected from natural blossoms in the Lake Klamath in Oregon, USA, to be used as healthy food. Marine nitrogen-fixing cyanobacteria have also been tested to feed fishes in aquacultures. The tilapia fish showed high growth rates when fed with marine cyanobacteria in indoor and outdoor cultures. Formidium valediranum has been used in India to serve as a complete aquaculture feed source based on its nutritional value and non-toxic nature. In view of the cyanobacterial significance as a food source, very little research has been performed and published about this. Let us now look at cyanobacterial emulsifiers. Halophilic cyanobacteria produce large amounts of exopolysaccharides, which can be relevant to oil recovery by decreasing its surface tension and increasing its solubility and motility. EPS, when gelated under alkaline conditions, was employed to remove dyes from textile effluent. The halophilic cyanobacterium, Apanthocapsa halophytica, was used for the production of EPS and its yield was increased to tenfold by immobilizing the cells on light diffusing optical fibers. Let us now come to the conclusions and future directions. The review demonstrates the versatility of cyanobacteria to biotechnological applications. They are potent sources of bioactive compounds, biofertilizers, bioplastics, energy, food, and have currently been used in drug discovery, medical diagnostics, and bioremediation. However, further research needs to focus on the satisfactory actinic culturing of these microorganisms in order to facilitate their exploitation. Additionally, new methods need to be developed to allow the cultivation of previously uncultivable strains. The methods should consider the organism's requirements in the field, and these conditions should be mimicked in the laboratory. The cultivation efforts should be directed towards unique environments, particularly those with extreme conditions of salinity, temperature, pH, UV, and light intensity. These environmental conditions are likely to contain novel strains with strong potential in biotechnology. To circumvent cultivability problem, metagenomics could serve as an alternative approach. This approach involves construction of metagenomic clone libraries from nucleic acids extracted directly from environmental samples. The clone libraries are then screened for the presence of functional genes that are involved in biosynthesis of certain biotechnologically significant compounds. These genes are transferred to cultivable hosts, which can directly be used for the production of desired compounds. Numerous compounds that have antibacterial and anti-algal activity have been isolated from different cyanobacteria. However, only limited compounds have been screened for their anti-fouling, antiviral, and anti-tumor activities. Recently, several potent antifouling, antiviral, and anti-tumor compounds have been isolated from macroalgae, sponges, and tunicates. These compounds are often present in small quantities, and in order to obtain sufficient amounts to harvest and extract many marine organisms. Cyanobacteria have been studied for a long time for their interesting morphology, diversity, and physiology. But pioneering work in the last decades has raised the level of these microbes to be viewed with favor in biotechnology relevant fields. Therefore, it is essential not only to understand and describe the diversity of cyanobacteria in yet unexplored habitats, but also to gainfully exploit them from various industrial applications. This requires combined efforts of taxonomists, molecular biologists, biochemists, engineers, and industry-related scientists, as well as politicians and policy makers.